Hey, I'm Laura Story, and thanks for joining me for this 5-session study based on my new book, I Give Up, The Secret Joy of a Surrendered Life. Before we get started, I want to tell you that the decision you made to do this Bible study was the right one. And it's not because of the greatness of this particular study, though I do pray that God uses it in a powerful way in your life, but because the decision to do a study of God's Word is a spiritual investment in your life, an active choice to nourish your soul with God's Word. If you're anything like me, there are a thousand things bombarding you, clamoring for your time, and it's really easy to get caught up in the busyness of this world. But God's Word calls us to something different. Romans 12 says, "Do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind." Why? In verse 2, it goes on to explain, "Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will." The more we're exposed to God's Word and submit our lives to His teaching, the more we are changed into His likeness and become more surrendered to His will. I love the way the late Eugene Peterson writes this verse in The Message. "Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life. Place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for Him. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out." The more we take our lives and place them before God, the more we will be changed from the inside out. So whether you're doing this study as a study with a group of friends or even just by yourself, dig in deep and ask the Lord to do something significant in your life over the next few weeks. Here's the thing. In my experience, people like to have their way. I know I like to have my way. I like to be in control. And we often go to God seeking His help with our will. "Here's my plan, God. I went ahead and just drafted it up for you. I'm just trying to help you out, really. So all I need is just your John Hancock right here." We think we know what's best, and we just need God to help us with our plan on our terms. But God is not interested in signing off on even our best-made plans. God is much more interested in our surrender to Him. So what is it anyway? And who in their right mind actually wants to surrender? When you think about what surrender is, it's relenting. It's giving up. It's saying, "This is mine, but you can have it." It's saying, "I really want to do it, and I really want to do it this way, but let's do it your way instead." Have you ever noticed you've never really heard any great war stories about the guy who surrendered? Because surrendering is losing. It's admitting defeat. It's saying, "I give up." Who in their right mind likes surrender? If you look up surrender, you will find words like resignation, abandonment, submission, abdication, capitulation, whatever these words mean anyway. But none of these words seem inspirational or uplifting when we read them. Yet, if you were a follower of Christ, surrender was actually the very first step you took in that relationship. Paul tells us in Ephesians 2 that it's by grace we are saved, not by works. Basically, there is no amount of trying, striving, pining, planning, negotiating, working, or willing it to happen that we can do to gain a right standing before God. Accepting grace literally requires giving up. So on one hand, surrender is very much ingrained in who we are as believers. Yet that doesn't make it easy.